Okay, so she said she has a question when it comes to reading the result of your CPAS. Shopee and Lazada both offer access, okay, and to their marketing solutions portal, which is the system backend, respectively, on Lazada and Shopee. So sales and revenue example, okay, so which your question is which data, what data should we be looking into? What's more accurate, the data on Facebook dashboard or the data from the MSP, which is the marketing solutions portal? Correct me if I'm wrong. Now, when it comes to this kind of question, how I understand it is that, you know, you're asking, should I trust Facebook Ads Manager data or should I trust, what do we call that, the MSP data, which is, you know, the Shopee data or Lazada data? I would say both are valid. But one thing you have to remember, when you're running advertisement to drive traffic from Facebook and Instagram to your Shopee or Lazada store, there is one thing that we call the dropout rate or so-called the friction. You see, that you have to take a look at this as really the journey of how people so-called in a way kind of like travel. Once I see your advertisement, I probably need to see your ads maybe 2 to 3 times to realize then I will choose to click or not. So depending on what kind of advertisement that you're putting up, it could be a carousel, it could be an instant experience, it could be a collection, you know. So when I click, not necessarily I'll be going over to Shopee. I'll be clicking and I probably open up your collection, which is, you know, a combination of your products, you know, to become an instant experience inside the Facebook ads, Facebook app, you know. So I'll be navigating on your products. If I don't see anything that I'm interested, I may not click over to your Shopee store. So the dropout or the friction could happen along the way. So you have to navigate. So basically, this is in my opinion, if you see about 50% conversion from click to landing page view, that should be something healthy, I would say. Because I was told that, because recently, you know, especially in Malaysia's case, I'm not sure about Philippines and Thailand and all that, but for Malaysia's case, Shopee recently adopted the UTM tracking. You know, when it comes to UTM tracking, you know, there is a lot of issue. Because back then, right, when we were running some campaign for our clients, I mean, we still have a few clients, though we don't take new ones anymore. Now, what happened was some people were actually, you know, when we were working with our client, the account manager from Shopee will respond, and somebody actually got about 6 cents per click, 5 cents per click. You know, at that point of time, we realized, I was actually thinking, okay, you have good cost per click, then what about landing? But what happened now is Shopee is really tracking the landing, and the dropout rate could be as high as 90% over, meaning that on Facebook side, you see 100 clicks, but when it comes to your landing page view, you only probably capture about 10% of it. It could be that bad. So you want to actually strike a balance. So along the way, you need to find the best combination, as in like the creative that you are creating, in order to effectively bring people over. So I would say both data, to answer this question from Lelen, both data are valid, okay? Both data are important to monitor. However, you want to monitor the effectiveness of your advertisement, you need to actually look at the dropout rate. So you want to try to maintain a healthy dropout rate, about 50%, which is reasonable. Okay, anything higher than that could be quite bad. All right, thank you for the question.